first of all, the way the Comelec has come out with a report is the fact that you, being a former legislator, you yourself have not followed the rules. They've said that 2010, you forgot to report your SOSA, and also in the 2016 elections. And in fact, they want to slap you with a fine of 60,000. What really happened?
Okay. In 2010, I was the campaign manager also of Noynoy Aquino, remember? I was not even my own campaign manager. And so I mixed up some receipts with Noynoy, between Noynoy's and mine, and I had to report Noynoy's first because his was the Liberal Party. So I was late. They gave you 30 days after elections. Then after that, you can't file anymore and you can't sit.
Okay.
Yeah.
Even if you won, you can't sit.
Yeah, it's crazy. Well, anyway, I sat and they allowed me to file later. So I filed late in 2010. All right.
Within the year.
No, I filed by August.
Okay.
Yeah.
So a few months after.
But I would have filed earlier, but they didn't allow me to file. Okay. But I took my oath as office as a senator, and they didn't want to call my attention that I'm not supposed to take my oath, so they allowed me to file. So I filed. So to say that I didn't file is not correct. It's not correct. I did file. Then in 2016, I have two offices. And my staff was busy packing because I had lost the elections. So when they started packing also my campaign materials. So again, I asked them for permission to June 15. I wrote Andy Bautista, the Comelec chair, for permission to file late, which means about 15 to 20 days late. That's all. He never, he responded, but he referred it to the commission and bank. The commission and bank never responded to me, so I didn't file. I can file now, but they never asked me to file now.
So is it right to say for 2016, you don't have a report?
I don't have a report now. In 2016, they allowed the Liberal Party to file late. They allowed Senator Drilon to file late. And they allowed Senator Marrojas to file late. But they didn't allow me to file late. Okay. But anyway, the law says that if you don't file for two...
Consecutive.
No, it doesn't
not
even have consecutive. Just two times you didn't file, you're disqualified. But I filed in 2010. Now, the law is very strict on that. If you don't file, you're disqualified. But they don't like to disqualify people. So they allowed me to file. In 2016, they didn't allow me to file, but they allowed the Liberal Party to file. They allowed Senator Drilon to file. They allowed Senator Marrojas to file late. So I said, wait, first things first. I filed in 2010. Whether you want to believe it or not, I filed in 2010 because I have the records. I have to report it.
And do you have the records of the Comelec accepting what you filed?
Yeah, but I don't even know if I have that. But
okay.
But anyway, I took my oath.
Okay, yes.
So that means I filed.
Yeah.
Because otherwise, you cannot take your oath unless you filed.
Yeah.
So they're wrong at the lower Comelec level. But they're just trying to stick to the letter of the law, which says if you don't file, you're out. If you don't file on time, you're out. You know, that is a crazy...
Yeah.
That's a crazy law because, one, if you don't file, even if you went to the election campaign, even if you won, if you don't file, you're not allowed to sit. And there's no such thing as late filing. But the Comelec always allows late filing. So when they allowed me to file late, then I file late. But late filing is not non-filing.
Yeah. Now, do you have proof, and I know the burden of proof isn't yours, but do you have proof that the Comelec accepted? It's like the same as the amnesty situation of Senator Trillanes. Did he file or did he not file? It became his burden to prove that he filed. Do you have proof that the Comelec accepted your late filing in 2010?
I have proof. But I have proof only in a copy, computer copy.
Yeah.
Not actual. So yes, I have proof. But the mere fact is that I took my oath of office means that I was not suspended, means that I filed on time. I mean, I filed.
Yeah.
Whether it was on time or not, doesn't matter. I filed.
Okay. Do you feel you're being singled out? Is there any other motive? Are you seeing any other motive?
I don't know. I don't think I'm being singled out because the campaign finance office is merely following the law.
Mm-mm.
And that law, I told you, it's crazy because it just says if you don't file after 30 days, you're out. No matter whether you won, no matter whether you're out. And it's not true that you're out because you're allowed to file late.
Yeah. Well, right now, I was reading and it turns out that the Comelec Finance Office is calling the attention of more than 450 candidates on non-filing twice. So it seems that there are many, whether sitting or not sitting, who file either late, too late, or don't file.
Don't file at all, yes.
Why is that? I mean, for a layman, a commoner, the person might be thinking, grabe naman tong mga politikong to. If we should follow the rules, we should follow the law, and file our income tax, why can't they file their own expense report?
Mabusisi. Talaga, it's mabusisi. You have to write down every expense that you made during the campaign.
Yeah.
Now, so what I did is I don't write down anymore the taxi fares, and I don't write down, because how can you do that? How can you campaign and at the same time keep track of all these little things? So I don't do the little things, but the big things I have to. You have to file.
Donations.
Yeah, I mean, when I advertise with ANC, I have to file that right away with Comelec. So there are many steps and processes. That's a very tedious position. That's a very tedious matter. Then everybody who gave you money, you're supposed to file. And then not only that, they're supposed to file their income tax returns so they show that they can afford to give money to you. It's really a lot of wasted.
Yeah. Now, Serge, you're one of the veterans. You're considered as an intellectual giant in the Senate. The question is, you lost in the last elections. Don't you consider this as that extra distraction, frankly, when you should be focusing on, let's say, your campaign, the branding, where to go? Don't you see this as an extra distraction that may slow you down?
No. Because the Supreme, the Comelec will decide this within this month.
Okay.
So it's not a distraction.
But if the Comelec does not go your way, are you going to take that as is?
Yeah, I'll take it as is.
Really?
Yeah.
You will not appeal?
No, I will not appeal anymore.
That's quite interesting. Why is that? You won't go all the way to the Supreme Court?
Useless. I mean, you know, there's already a case in the Supreme Court anyway. So let them decide that case. See, the Liberal Party was brought to the Supreme Court for having filed late in 2016. So I'll let the Supreme Court decide that. But at the Comelec level alone, they cannot say that I did not file. They can say that I filed late.
Yeah. Yeah. Now, I was reading some of your past interviews. You said that you are confident that once the Comelec and Bank hears your defense, that they will vote in favor of you and not disqualify you.
Yes, that's true.
Okay.
That's why I feel relaxed.
Yeah, but why are you feeling confident given the fact it's quite surprising given that, I mean, you've been a three-termer senator, you're coming back, you're one of the veterans. Out comes the Comelec Finance Office suddenly saying, we want Serge Osmeña perpetually disqualified. That was big news. It was surprising coming from that office.
Yeah. Well, I mean, the Comelec Finance Office really had to file that case against me. But they're willing to have the Supreme Court, but the Comelec and Bank decide on it.
Okay.
And that's all I'm asking.
Okay. I'm quite curious because I was surprised when you said, you know, Karen, whatever the Comelec decides, that's it.
Yeah.
I mean, you are 74 and you've won, been a senator for 3 terms. Why wouldn't you fight it out when you are showing in the surveys? Because this, that's the irony of it all. Without much effort, you've come in number 8. You're not on television. Right? You haven't been active, you haven't been criticizing. Yes. In other words, you haven't been out, and yet you figured at number 8. So it means there's something about you or your track record, could be name recall or whatever, but the people want you back, and yet you're saying, you know, Karen, if the Comelec doesn't vote in favor of me, I'm letting this go. When you can win. Why well, now? Yeah. You can win.
Yes, but I'm saying that because I'm sure the Comelec will let me go.
That's it. Yes. It's not because, Karen, I'm tired. You know,
I'm not tired. No, no.
You're really saying because you're confident that Comelec will vote in favor of you.
Yes.
So there is no option. You're not thinking there's a 10% chance they might surprise you and say you're not going to.
Oh, no, well, there's a 10% chance, but I'll take the chance. In other words, hindi naman ako sigurista. Pag ayaw ng Comelec, di okay lang. Okay.